creating the campaign speech rights of other people. That's an appropriate. Well, you're not going by rules because you're allowing this to be affixed to the building.
Yes.
When that is not within the rules, that's a violation. We'd be perfectly happy to see those signs removed. But to have those signs allowed, to have that political speech allowed, and to have this political speech censored is unconstitutional.
And I live near Round Valley. There's a line of cars trying to get in Round Valley. Right. All from disadvantaged areas to vacate it. I'm one of the hottest days for the board of July.
So the governor is not right.
All
the governor has different rights than the people of New Jersey. The governor has different rights than the people of New Jersey who built this house, who paid for this house, whose taxes support this house. Their free speech is going to be abridged here, but this is going to be allowed. Their political speech is abridged, but his political speech is allowed. I just want to be crystal clear that our members are having their free speech rights abridged, and that the governor is being held to a different standard, that the governor is allowed to have political speech, but that the people of New Jersey are being prevented from their political speech. That's clear? Okay. Thank you very much. We are going to continue to stand here because it's highly inappropriate and we believe it's unconstitutional. I understand, and I would love to see you protect it from that sign that's been affixed to the building illegally.
We're all in this together. We're all in this together.
We've got a double standard. There's a double
standard.
So in other words, we'll have our free speech rights when we don't need our free speech rights down the road. But when it's critical, when the issue is hot, when the message matters, our free speech rights are going to be abridged.
So what you need to recognize is that we're not there on that road. Situations arise that aren't anticipated.
And in the meantime, shouldn't those signs be removed since there is clearly a rule that you've expressed to me that there can be no signage affixed to the building? We were told that. No signage affixed to the building. Oh, so this is an anti-demonstration rule? This is an anti-demonstration because we've had those ruled unconstitutional by the Supreme Court of the United States as well. Well, obviously not, because you're not following the First Amendment of the United States. That's a real problem. It's a real problem when you are suppressing the free speech right of these people, but you're allowing other political speech. You, as a government agent, are discriminating between the speech rights of different citizens. That's inappropriate. But the best would be to have equal treatment. Either remove those signs or allow us to put our signs. But having unequal treatment, that's not an opinion, that's the Constitution of the United States. That's not an opinion. I understand. I understand, but you are abridging our rights to have the same speech rights as everybody else.
So if you park this vehicle now, you have a press right around you.
But you're treating us differently, is that correct?
You have a press right now.
Okay.
So your
is this a state building?
We are not stopping.
I understand, and I understand this is your council. So I'm being told that the governor has the right to put political speech and fix it to the building, but this is our attorney, but the demonstrators do not have the same free speech rights.
We'll talk about